This is an iconic symbol of France and one of the world's best known commemorative monuments. Today we're taking a closer look at the Arc de Triomphe. Welcome to Earth from Space. This striking high-resolution image of the Arc de Triomphe and its surroundings was captured by SkySat, a fleet of satellites that have just joined ESA's third-party mission program in April 2022. The triumphal arch was commissioned by Napoleon in 1806 to celebrate the military achievements of the French armies. The arch stands at the center of the Place Charles de Gaulle, the meeting point of 12 grand avenues which form a star, or étoile. This is why it is also referred to as the Arch of Triumph of the Star. The names of all French victories and generals are inscribed on the arch's inner and outer surfaces, while the tomb of the unknown soldier from World War I lies beneath its vault. The Arc de Triomphe's location at the Place Charles de Gaulle places it at the heart of the capital and the western terminus of the Avenue des Champs-Élysées. Often referred to as the most beautiful avenue in the world, the Champs-Élysées is known for its theatres, cafes, and luxury shops. This image, captured on the 9th of April 2022, was provided by SkySat, a fleet of 21 very high-resolution satellites capable of collecting images multiple times during the day. SkySat's satellite imagery, with 50 centimeter spatial resolution, is high enough to focus on specific areas, identifying objects such as vehicles and shipping containers. SkySat data, along with PlanetScope, are both owned and operated by Planet Labs. They serve numerous commercial and governmental applications. These data are now available through ESA's third-party mission program, enabling researchers, scientists, and companies from around the world the ability to access planets' high-frequency, high-resolution satellite data. Within this program, Planet joins more than 50 other missions to add near-daily PlanetScope imagery, SkySat imagery, and RapidEye archive data to this global network. To find out more on how to apply to the EarthNet program and get started with Planet data, visit Earth Online.